Hi, everyone. Aaron here for Zolotech, and macOS Monterey 12 release candidate is now available. Now, this has been out for a day or so, and this particular update version is a little different. If we go to About This Mac, you'll see it says version 12.0.1, even though it's a release candidate. The final version is not out yet, but Apple says that this will be made available to the public on Monday, October 25th. So Apple has said that, and this should be the final version. If we click on this version number, you'll see the build number is 21A558. And so if Apple does not find any additional issues with this, this will be the first version released to the public of macOS Monterey. Now, as you can see, it's got a .1 at the end, which is unusual, but it looks like Apple's going to push this one out. Now, as far as if you're on the beta program and you want to remove that, you can always do that by going to your preferences, then going to software update, click on advanced, click OK, it will recheck. And once it does, you'll have the option here to unenroll your device or restore defaults. So you can just restore the defaults here, go back. However, I would wait to make sure they don't push out another version of macOS Monterey before they do that on Monday. So just hold off a little bit and then maybe restore at that point if you want to remove the beta from your device. Now, macOS Monterey gets a lot of features that iOS 15 received. Everything from FaceTime with spatial audio and voice isolation and wide spectrum. It's very hard to show you since I'm screen recording, but it gets portrait mode and more. And that's what it gets with this, along with grid view and FaceTime links for inviting friends. So FaceTime, you're probably familiar with this. I'll try and show it in the final version of the video, but you're probably already familiar with this. Also with messages, you now get shared with you. If someone shares with you something in messages and you go into, say, Safari, within Safari, you can see that we have shared with you. So people that have messaged me directly, there's links to what they've shared. I can click on this and it will open messages. Also within messages, you have photos displayed as stacks. So if we go into messages, within messages, you can see that there's a bunch of photos here. I can just swipe through. So I can swipe left to right, just like we can in iOS 15 now. So you have that option, and all of those shared for you or shared with you options carry over. So if someone shares something from, say, your messages for photos, it will show up in photos. If they share a link in Safari, it will show up in Safari and so on. Now, Safari gets some updates as well. You may have already noticed it looks a little bit different. And if we go to Apple, we'll go to Apple here, and maybe we'll add a tab. You'll see we have our tabs at the bottom. However, they've given us the option to change this around just like we can on iOS and iPadOS. So if we go into our preferences, we have a tab layout of compact or separate. Separate will make it look like it did before, and then you have that option. You can also create tab groups just like you can in iOS 15 and macOS. So you can see here, I had some issues with my bathtub, so I'm looking for parts. I created a group. Here's an Apple group. Here's another one. And if I want to see all the tabs, you can just click on it, see the different tabs if there's tabs open. So you can create groups of different tabs that you use regularly. So that's something that they've updated here. Now, they've also brought focus to the Mac as well. So just like we have it on iOS, we now have it on macOS. So if we click this button here, we have our different focus modes, and you'll see the different focus modes here. We can fully customize these by going to Focus Preferences. So if we want to set up Do Not Disturb and allow certain people to communicate with us, we can do that. We can turn it on from here or adjust notifications. It's the same thing you have on iOS, and they all sync across all devices. So you'll have all of your different preferences here. So focus modes has been there. And also quick notes that carries over from iPad is here as well. If you're on a website with a note, for example, you have the option for quick notes. So if we go to Safari again, maybe go to Apple. If I had a quick note created for Apple here, we'd be able to see that here with a link in it as well. You're probably already familiar with that, but you have that now as well. Within Notes, if we open Notes back up, you can see here's the notes for macOS Monterey. We now have the option for tags. So there's tags in here. And also if you're sharing this with someone, maybe you're using the share option in the upper right, you'll now have the option to see when they mention you or when they update something you're working on. It will now pop up and show you that. So that's something they've updated. We also have the option to AirPlay to Mac now. So I can AirPlay from my phone. So let me do that. So now you can see I'm screen mirroring from my iPhone, AirPlaying it through my Mac. So it works through here. You can do that with music as well. If you want to AirPlay to a different device, you have that option. And then of course you can go back if you don't want to use that. But it's a really nice way to easily share between your iPhone or iPad and Mac. Now within Photos, we get that live text feature as well. So if we go into Photos, and within Photos, here you can see the iOS 15.1 beta 3. And if we just hover our mouse over it here, we can highlight this text and then we can copy it if we want to do that. We can look it up, copy it, paste it somewhere else. So it works with that. You also have visual lookup as well. So if we go to a landmark, now you can see here's a landmark and we have the inspector or the eye, and there's two little stars here. If I click on those, you'll see I have the little landmark icon. And if I click on that, it identifies what it is. One World Trade Center tells us more information about it, about the area and more. So it gives us more information. This works with flowers and pets and that sort of thing as well. And we just have more information in Photos, just like we do on our iPhone as well. So visual lookup is built in. Now with macOS Monterey, we gain shortcuts. We've had it on iPad and iPhone for a while, and now we have the same thing on Mac. So we have all of our shortcuts synced between devices, and we can create new ones, and then they'll sync back to iPhones. So if you want to work with a full-size keyboard, maybe do a little bit of scripting, you can do that, and just drag that in and create a shortcut. Now you still have Automator, but this is basically going to be Automator for the future. So this is a way to kind of do most of those things. And then you have all of your different options here as well as I scroll down. So they've added shortcuts and it's great to have it easily sync between all of them as well. Now in Maps, they've updated that as well. So if we go into Maps, and within Maps, you can see that I have an interactive globe. Now this is on M1 Max for some reason only. It's a 3D globe with enhanced detail for mountains, oceans, and more. So if maybe I zoom into Los Angeles here, we'll just keep going in, or maybe we'll pick San Francisco. We can get a little closer there. Those maps are updated as well. We can get a lot more detail. So if we zoom right in, we'll keep going. We'll go to the Golden Gate Bridge. And as we continue to zoom in, you'll see we have a lot more detail. And so we have the bridge itself, and we'll have overpasses and underpasses. And if we switch to 3D, we can sort of see underneath it. If we move over here, you'll see that it's a 3D model of the bridge. And then we have different things such as trees and more. So they're much more detailed. Maps is updated with that. We even have elevation and landmarks and more. So you do need an M1 to have a lot of this detail, but it is updated for macOS Monterey. Now there's additional privacy in this update as well. And some of the privacy has to do with mail. So there's mail privacy protections that help prevent senders from tracking your mail activity. They've also added the record indication, as you can see here with the little orange dot, to let you know that the microphone is in use. Since I'm recording this video, you'll see the little record indicator just like we did on iPhone before. Now we also have iCloud Plus with Private Relay, but that's in beta right now, and also Hide My Email. So those things are available for Safari and Mail, but are still in beta at this time. Now there are a lot of other little additions as well to macOS Monterey. Universal Control is still not here. So if we go to Displays, wait for it here, and we can switch or mirror, but we still don't have universal control that's enabled. So maybe we'll have that in the future, but we don't have it. Apple has said that it's coming later on. So right now we don't have universal control, which allows us to use the mouse seamlessly between a Mac and another Mac with the same keyboard and mouse, or a Mac and iPad and back and forth. Just drag to the edge and it will jump to the iPad. No special software required. So that's something that will be coming later on. Now, of course, there's additional updates with this update, such as Siri and more, and the Control Center and notifications and more. So everything has been updated in this update. If you've watched any of the other beta updates, all of those things are here, but what I just mentioned, everything is still included in macOS Monterey. There may be some additional features coming down the road though. Like I said earlier, macOS Monterey is available on October 25th, as you can see here. So you'll be able to install it on all supported devices, and there will be a lot of other features as well, such as SharePlay and more. So if you want to see all the new features, you can go here. If you just want to review them, if you haven't seen them in a while, and of course, I'll be doing a separate video covering everything that I can here as well. If you have any other additional things you've found, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below, and I'm looking forward to Universal Control as well, but again, we'll have to wait a little while for that. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed this video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.